Chair, I'll talk about all the last year because we still haven't really agreed where it goes, so we just have our first agenda setting meeting today. We looked at budget options last year, which was the change to library open times, and we looked at the under 70s council tax discount, the two pieces of task and finish on that, which were, I thought were very useful, just there that we brought to come back on the libraries. We've just undertaken an extensive piece of task and finish work on the local welfare assistance scheme, which was really, really, I think that report that's being produced has been really positive and hopefully it will be well received. And that's looking at our funding available for what did replace the crisis loans, the UVP used to fund crisis loans, no longer does so. That would devolve to local authorities and now the funding is about to cease. So we met and spent a whole day gathering evidence and statements from CAB, Wired, the Food Bank, just to see how things were looking and how we could, if possible, extend and maximise the £900,000 that we have in the kitty, to maximise the shelf life basically at most of it. But we are going to meet again in a year's time for an update on things. I suspect things will not be improved because the funding has now come to an end. So with regards to the coming years where everyone hasn't been agreed yet, we've certainly got some things to look at. But it's been a good year and I'm really talking to you. Thank you.
Thank you. Mike, do you want to come
to reiterate the comments from Jeanette, we've had our first agenda setting meeting today and what we're going to look at this year. We give emergency travel between £30 and £40 million every year, and what our committee want to do this year is look at what we're getting for that. And we're going to look at bus passes. We're an authority that give bus passes to people aged 60.
And we like them too, mate.
Yes, I'm sure you do, but it's hard times. So that's something we're going to do. That's just one of the snippets we're going to look at. After mentioning the bus passes, I won't tell you something else that I've been planning to look at this year. But last year, yes, the committee really worked well together and we did some good task accounts. And Appendix 1, page 26, it's got us all there, ladies and gentlemen. What we did last year, we've got in our budget, we've got £1.9 billion worth of highways. So we had a task and finish on that to make sure that our money was well spent. We had the transformation from Colas over to Van Nuttall, and we're going to continue to monitor that. Van Nuttall came in all singing and all dancing, and the reality of it now, a few months down the line, I think is not bearing out the expectations that we had. So yes, it's all there. We had a good year, and we're looking forward to this year, particularly with the cuts that we're going to suffer. And believe me, this isn't, honestly, it's not party political.
No.
For whatever reason, you know, we've got these cuts to manage, and between us, between the three parties, we've got to look at how best we can serve this council. And when I say this council, what I really mean is the people out there.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yes, thanks,
Chair.
The one thing I wanted to say is that we've got an indication from the executive that there will be a budget information coming through to Cabinet in mid-September. So I would ask that the work programmes can reflect that by keeping a slot there to deal with that. From a families and wellbeing point of view, picking up on what Phil said before and also what Wendy said, this is a very, very busy committee. It's got a huge remit. We have lost a little bit this time by antisocial behaviour, which was bizarrely said with us being taken into another committee now. But the remit is very wide and it is a constant constantly exercises your mind to do the best in handling the agendas. having said that, everybody who's on the committee does work very hard to achieve that. We set up at the beginning of last year health and care panel, that's been meeting regularly, and as Wendy said, there's a lot of monitoring needs doing in health, particularly around the university teaching hospital, which is still struggling. But we also did pieces of work around monitoring samples of co-care providers and revisiting the report we did on the crisis for Wirral and also on care homes and the recommendations that we made on the sort of that. And I'm sure we'll be just as busy on the health and care panel this year. The children's, well, the attainment subcommittee tended to focus mostly on education achievement, and though there were other issues looked at, the focus does seem to go back to education, and we are looking to try and develop that into having a broader remit. It hasn't got a committee, but hopefully a committee next week will agree that it's renamed the children's subcommittee, and that we broaden the remit to look at a much wider remit. We were going to look at the issue of early years provision, but again we've widened that, and our first piece of work we do through that committee will be something that we've named giving rural children the best start in life, because that enables us to look right across from pre-birth through to the whole of the early years, and that's a piece of work that the members of that city will concentrate their attention on, looking at the cost of the course in the life as well. So I don't know who will be on from the different parties there, but that will be an interesting piece of work that we do every year. We have regular reports, as you know, monitoring performance on policy initiatives and the like, and they go to committee. And the other thing that we've had are the spotlight sessions, which have been in the main well received. Some of them weren't so well attended in the first part of the year, but they did gather a momentum towards the end of the year, and we've got our first one for this year. I think it's the 20th of July, if that's agreed by committee next week, when we're looking at the implications of Vanguard status, which will have achieved, which initiative to reduce dependence on hospital admissions and develop services that support people in the community. And so that's open to all members of the council, and you receive an invitation if you want to come and have a listen to what that's all about. From the task and finish point of view, we've done some really meaty pieces of work on this committee. Francis was one, the care homes was another. We're involved in safeguarding, which has gone on longer than we would have liked, and it's also taught us that to have too many people on a panel is actually counterproductive, because it's just really difficult to get everybody together with officers at the time you need it. So if you want to keep the focus on the piece of work, it is probably easier to have a smaller group, as long as it is big enough to get the work done. But safeguarding, we hope we'll finish in the next few weeks. We move on then to a piece of work on avoidable hospital admissions. And after that, I'm not quite sure what it is, I can't remember. So we'll continue to be busy throughout this year. And just thank people that have been on the committee and taking part in work. One of the things that Mike asked me to do yesterday was look at a report he'd written for full council next week, which is detailing what's happened over scrutiny in the last year. It's an officer report, but the information in that is heartening, really, because I did notice the number of members who have been involved in task and finish work has increased remarkably, really, which is a good thing. I think we are establishing ourselves in a way that we can tackle this task that it is ours to complete. And that's it, really. I'm sure we're all open to questions if anybody wants to ask us a question. But if not, I think that's the last item on the agenda.